Happy Thursday afternoon. Chuck Karstensen here. Video number 38, Course in Miracles. And one of the reasons I like doing this and like studying the course is the lessons that it gives are really very simple and plain. But when you read them, like the one I'm sharing today, you're like, oh, I do what I should not be doing instead of do what I should be doing. And sometimes we're not even aware of it. So if you're like me and you do, for example, I'm talking about faith versus faithlessness today, and you find yourself, a person of faith, find yourself doing things that somebody of faithlessness would be doing, it's good to be aware of them and not get down on yourself about them. And remember that God's truth, God's love is always available for you, and it's unchanging in there. And some of it is our awareness, which I've talked about before, of what we need to know and what we're learning. And faith is a learning thing, where love, like I said, is unchanging and always available. Faith is something we basically learn and grow into. So today, sharing about faith versus faithlessness, I got a couple notes here I want to share. There's much more in the course, but I want to communicate what is the difference. You probably had not thought of faithlessness exactly this way. Well, I've talked about some of these things before. In fact, even a little bit in my last video, faithlessness, I didn't talk about faithlessness, but some of these other terms, faithlessness would always limit, which makes sense. You're limiting what God can do, God's power, and attack. And many times we find ourselves attacking other people and judging other people. So then you're in faithlessness when you're limiting what God can do, and then when you find yourself attacking, where faith would remove all limitations and make whole, make complete, bring oneness. So we talked about separateness before in the last video. Faithlessness would destroy and separate. And that's a lot of what I talked about last video in a different way. And faith would unite and heal, which is what we're working towards. And hopefully that's where you're at. So, and then faithlessness, another one I had here, and there's many, but I just wanted to share a couple more or one more. Faithlessness will keep you little and keep you in your little kingdoms, barren and separate. I'll explain that more in a bit. Where faith would help the Holy Spirit prepare ground for the most holy garden. So one of my things in my learning today, they were talking about a cloud and this little splinter that gets separated off, and we create our little kingdom. And I've talked before about entering the kingdom of God, entering the kingdom of heaven. But most people, and I find myself there, and really the awareness of being there and saying, oh, I'd like to be in that kingdom of heaven spot, comes. We are in this cloud. We are splintered off from the kingdom by our faithlessness and by our guilt, and among other things that we've talked about before. So we find ourselves in these separate little barren desert kingdoms where there isn't much growth. And when you think spiritually, you think growing, being nurtured, and then having a harvest. That is a spiritual principle. But if you find yourself in that barren place, that cloud where you're splintered off from the kingdom of God, that's where you're at. And like I said earlier, love and truth is always available. It's unchanging, and it's there. So then, as a learning tool, you must shift, now being in awareness of faithlessness, and a couple of those examples I gave you, shift to faith, which would be very simple. It would unite and heal. You make the shift to uniting and healing. You make the shift to having the Holy Spirit help prepare the ground for the harvest, instead of thinking on limited terms, limited mindset. You think in the more abundant, wholeness, prosperous mindset. And I know some religious people don't like that thinking. And guess what? Their gardens are very barren and they're not growing the kingdom very much. And they would be an attack. And even saying that, I caution myself for saying that, because that's not the correction I want to make for people. It's just, I want to bring the awareness of some of the limitations that people put themselves in and that I find myself in. And then this, why I love this course so much and why I like to share some of the things occasionally with you, is it's an opportunity to grow, it's learning, and it's advancing my trust in what's constant, the love, the truth of God, the promises of God. Compared to, I can say before, I would be more rattled, more distressed over the challenges of my life. And I've had more challenges lately than probably before, but I don't feel like they are challenges because I feel like, oh, I'm coming right through. I'm removing my limitations. But I do catch myself in those moments of faithlessness where I'm like, oh, there's limits and I'm stuck here. It's like, wait a minute, that's faithlessness. How about faith? That sounds better. So hope this helps you today. I'll again talk to you soon. Try to do at least 2 to 3 of these a week now going forward. Have a blessed day and reach out anytime if you have any questions, anything we can help you with, anything we can pray about or for you with.